Om Namah Shivaya students, in today's video I have uploaded 5 reference to context from the poem A Roadside Stand. You will solve this reference to context in your English literature classwork copy. You will refer to your book and also all the explanatory videos of this poem which I have already uploaded in our YouTube channel. I have explained the entire poem stanza wise in minute details. I have given explanation of this poem in minute detail, so I am very much sure that all of you can easily write down the answers. Reference number 1. The little old house was out with a little new shed in front at the edge of the road where the traffic sped. A roadside stand that too pathetically pled, it would not be fair to say for a dole of bread, but for some of the money the cash whose floor supports the flower of cities from sinking and withering faint. Question number 1. Where was the roadside stand located? Question number 2. What was the roadside stand pleading for? Question number 3. What figure of speech is presented in the words flower of cities? Question number 4. How is the flower of cities prevented from fainting? Reference number 2. The polished traffic passed with a mind ahead, or if ever aside a moment, then out of sorts at having the landscape marked with the artless paint of signs that with N turned wrong and S turned wrong, offered for sale wild berries in wooden quarts, or crook-necked golden squash with silver warts, or beauty raised in a beautiful mountain scene. Question number 1. What does the polished traffic represent? What figure of speech is it? Describe the attitude of the polished traffic with reference to the above lines. What had marred the landscape according to the people driving by? Prepare a list of the objects being sold in the roadside stand. Reference number 3. And ask for some city money to fill in hand, to try if it will not make our being expand, and give us the life of the moving pictures promise that the party in power is said to be keeping from us. It is in the news that all these pitiful kin are to be bought out and mercifully gathered in to live in villages next to the theatre and the store where they won't have to think for themselves any more. Question number 1. What do the people at the roadside stand long for? What is moving pictures promise? What is in the news? Who are they referred to? Reference number 4. Sometimes I feel myself I can hardly bear the thought of so much childish longing in vain. The sadness that lurks near the open window there, that waits all day in almost open prayer for the squeal of brakes, the sound of a stopping car, of all the thousand selfish cars that pass. Just want to inquire what a farmer's prices are, and one did stop but only to plough up grass, in using the yard to back and turn around, and another to ask the way to where it was bound, and another to ask could they sell it a gallon of gas. They couldn't, this crossly they had none, didn't it see? Question number 1. What is it that the poet can hardly bear? Question number 2. Whose childish longing does the poet refer to? Question number 3. Which figure of speech has the poet used in the line, the sadness that lurks near the open window? Question number 4. What is their open prayer? Question number 5. Why are the cars that pass by said to be selfish? Question number 6. Why did one or another of the cars stop? And the last reference, it has been marked as number 8, but it will be number 5. Know in country money the country scale of gain, the requisite lift of spirit has never been found, or so the voice of the country seems to complain, I can't help owning the great relief it would be to put these people at one stroke out of their pain. Question number one, what does the poet mean by the lines, no in country money, the country scale of gain, the requisite lift of spirit has never been found? Question number two, why does the voice of the country seem to complain? Question number three, how does the poet feel in the above extract? Question number four, what would give the poet great relief? So you will solve all these five reference to context in your classwork copy. For the figures of speech, I have made a separate video where I have discussed all the important figures of speech used in this poem. You can also refer to that video as well. In my next video, I will be uploading the short and the long answers of this poem. Till then, thank you. Om Namah Shivaya.